next guest. Our next guest, we're back. Our next guest is a great lady, a great actress, and somebody I had the pleasure of working with for 8 wonderful years on Who's the Boss. Here's a scene from our very first episode.
Hey! Hey! What's going on here?
Johnny! No, Johnny! Johnny's your date!
It's your date? I thought you were getting attacked. What are you doing rolling around on the floor?
We weren't rolling on the floor. We were picking up a broken plate.
Both of you?
It was a big plate.
Angela, who is this?
Well, Grant, you're not going to believe this, but this is my new housekeeper.
Housekeeper? Angela, this is the ugliest woman I've ever seen.
Please welcome my friend, my dear friend, Judith Light. Look at that girl. Seat there.
Hello.
Judy Light.
Good morning.
Judy Light.
Good morning.
So?
I thought you were going to show a clip of us kissing.
No, well, that I wanted to set up. Well, we have another clip here or two.
Oh, good.
Because you're going to be here a while.
I'm glad.
This is like, you know, I was going to devote a whole hour to you.
Oh, thank you.
Yes, I mean it. But then I got Emerald, so, you know.
Who is so fabulous.
Isn't he great?
He's so
He's
fabulous.
Really great. But forget him. Forget him. Forget him. Listen. So what do you think of the digs, first of all? I got to ask you. Because, you know, Judith's like, you know, she's a good eye for, you know.
Oh.
Pretty good, no?
It's
yes?
It's fabulous.
Yeah, I like the people I brought in just for you today.
Yeah. No,
yeah. Well, we're so happy to have you here, Judith.
I'm
you
happy
know
to
that
be
you,
here.
You actually complete the Who's the Boss cast.
Yes, I know.
Because, you know, Danny and Alyss were on,
right,
and Catherine was
right,
on.
Right.
Did you see the kids?
Oh, my God. It was so amazing. And when you danced with Danny, I could not believe. It was like, and I asked them backstage if you guys rehearsed that before.
They both remembered.
He taught this to the kids when they were so little that it's still in their body.
Well, yeah, you make them do it till they're 17.
I know.
You know. Like, there was real cute at 10. At 17, they're like, come on, give me a
but
break.
He was great.
Yeah, they
he
both
great.
How about Alyss?
Alyss
knew.
Everything, everything, everything.
It was great.
You're a good teacher. You're
well, thank
a good
you.
Teacher.
Thank you very much. So it's wonderful to have you here.
Thank you. It's wonderful to be here. Really, it's great to see you. I don't get to see him in L.A. ever, so I had to fly across the country to see him.
Yeah. Well, you know, being a talk show host, it's,
yes.
You know, it's a time in my life when...
Yeah, but you know, you've done everything, which is so incredible. And I was just saying to her, who was my manager, who was with us all during the time of Who's the Boss,
yeah.
He said, this is perfect for you.
Well, thank you.
You are just
thank
great
Thank you very
at
much.
This.
But I got the job. Let's move on.
Okay. No kidding.
No, I don't. Now, listen, so we were looking at pictures of Who's the Boss, and you had some outfits that we were reeling. In laughter, rolling in laughter, I mean. I have like a picture
So we're going
to
make fun of
it. No, I'm not going to make fun
no,
of
are.
It. But
it's
I mean,
okay.
It's just a couple That's here. Okay. Like this one here.
What?
Well, let's start here. Let's start with this one. This one here. You what? Were big on this shoulder pads thing. and the big glasses.
I know. Yeah. They asked
look,
me
look,
if
they
I
even,
this
they
show.
Got bigger here. On this one, they got a little bit bigger. You look...
No.
You could be...
yeah.
Here you look a little bit like a linebacker with glasses.
Yeah. Well, I can't watch the show. It's the things
it's really,
and the hair and the
well,
stuff.
Me too. You know, me, I feel like a man in search of a hairdo.
Yeah.
I mean, my hair is like so bizarre.
No, your hair's great now. You had a little trouble then.
Yeah, it was a little bit. Yeah. Yeah, here's a famous picture. This was one of the great moments we had.
Yeah.
When Frank Sinatra came and did the show. It's a wonderful day.
It was great.
That was a good time.
It was an amazing time. It was the best, I think I'd say it was the best 8 years of my life.
We had a good time.
We really did.
We really did. Do you watch So I watch the reruns, you know. I find myself doing it. I turn it on, I'm on. I watch it. I can't,
You know, I watch it sometimes, but then I look at the way I looked, and it's a little difficult.
But I just listen mostly. I don't even want to see what I look like anymore. Didn't you almost turn that down? You almost turned down Who's the Boss, right?
I was up for these. When you start auditioning for stuff, and I had just gotten to L.A. from New York, and I had left the soap opera, and I got there, and I was
Karen Wolick on One Life. Couple of Emmys.
Right.
Sobbed incessantly for years.
I did. Yes. I did for 5 years.
Yes. That's, and she was like a hooker or something, wasn't she?
We like to say prostitute.
Okay.
But...
Semantics.
Right, exactly.
So, but go ahead.
So I was up for these three shows, and there was one of them was called You're the Boss.
Oh, yeah, You're the Boss.
You're the That's Boss. Right. That's the cover of pilot cover. Yeah. And then a thing called Staff of Life and another thing called Command 5. And so you have
I would have loved to have seen Command 5.
Wait, don't you love Staff of Life? So it was about a staff of a soap opera. Show, so they said you have to put something in first position, and I didn't know what to put in first position, and I said, okay, I just came off a soap opera. Herb said to me, you got to make a decision. Right. I said, I can't make a decision. He said, make a decision. I said, okay, Staff of Life, I'll put that in first position. I go in, I audition for Staff of Life. You've all heard of Staff of Life.
famous show.
And then they said, we still want you to audition with Tony Danza for You're the Boss. And I said to Herb, you know, I auditioned for one, and he said to me, you're scared, you're a nervous wreck, and because of you and your reputation and everything,
I beat up the people I work with.
That's why I was scared. And so, he said, pack up your stuff, go in, do the audition. So I went in, and I met him.
I got the screen test. So look, see that? You're the boss.
My weekend has nothing to do with my promotion.
You'll never know unless you don't go.
Who are you anyway? Jiminy Cricket? Tony, I'm a big girl.
Listen, I'm telling you can do this on your own. It's like Sinatra said.
Sinatra?
Sure, through it all when there was doubt. I ate it up and I spit it out. I faced them all and I stood tall, but I did it my way.
I don't believe it. We're talking about my life, and you're giving me the philosophy of the Sands Hotel.
We were young. I tell you, dude, a lot of times I find myself, like, you know, recoiling when I see, you know, myself that many years ago. But I don't know. There's something about being on screen with you that makes it fun.
It's true.
So, you got a favorite episode?
Yeah.
We did 199 episodes. You got a favorite? Right.
I do. It was actually the time that we did the story about your father dying.
Oh, yeah. Well, he dedicated a show to my father.
It was amazing because it was so... It was the first time that I mean, Tony is an extraordinary actor. I mean, he has an incredible range. But you didn't see the depth of the dramatic actor until that show. Wow. And there was a moment in that show that was so amazing and so funny. Remember, you knocked over the urn with the ashes in it?
And you think it's my father.
And I thought it was your father.
And you think it's my father's ashes.
Right.
And I go get the dustbuster.
Right. Yeah. But it had all this poignancy and...
That was a good show.
And it was just beautiful. It was just...
So now you talk about, you know, me being an actor, but you're like the trained woman, Carnegie Mellon.
Yes. And you used to make fun of me.
I did. I made a lot of fun of her.
But it was so great. But, you know, you taught me so much. I mean, I didn't really know about comedy until I worked with you. And he really trained me. And he used to stand behind us and teach us how to hold for laughs. Mm. It was so incredible.
One thing I didn't teach you, though, is this is what Judith was the brave... One of the things that was so great about Judith is how brave she was. She'd do anything for a laugh. Anything. She'd say to me, will they laugh? I'd say, yes. She'd say, cut it off. I mean, so... And that's why it worked. Because when you look like that and you're willing to do anything for a joke, we got a good start on that, Judith.
Yeah.
Judith, speaking of doing anything for a laugh.
Oh, God. Oh,
we were thinking that maybe since you were here, we might do a little cooking. We had Emeril here.
Yes.
We figured you're a great cook, so we're going to do a little... We're going to make... We're going to make a, you know, years ago, I taught Judith my grandmother's eggplant parmigiana recipe,
which is amazing.
It's pretty good.
It's amazing. And I get more compliments on that than anything I make.
Well, thank you. That's very nice of you. But we're going to teach you something else now. We're going to make a little bit of pizza. So when we come back, we're going to make some homemade pizza in our kitchen with Judith Light. So stay with us. So we're back in the kitchen, and we're here with Judith Light, and I'm going to teach you how to make a little bit of pizza. You ready, Ju?
I am. I took my shoes off. Okay. I'm ready, and I'm wearing the bracelet that you gave me when we finished Who's the Boss.
Oh, so nice. It's nice of you to do that. Thank you very much. Do we have a little clip here? I think we have a little bit of an outtake just for a little hors d'oeuvre.
Egg.
Egg.
It's an easy.
Tell, we've been in the kitchen before. All right, so look, first thing you gotta do is proof your yeast. You put about half a cup of water in with the yeast,
warm
and
water.
A little sugar, a little warm water, and you proof the yeast, okay? That, we're gonna make a little bit of a well. We're gonna use, about a teaspoon of salt, a little olive oil, okay? And then this would have been proofed by now, and if you do it like about 10 minutes before.
Uh-huh, it gets bubbly,
okay,
right?
It gets bubbly.
Right.
We'll put a little bit of that in there, and then we'll fold this around, right? We'll fold all that around.
Did and little by the
my grandmother, I used to watch her do this.
Really?
Yeah, we used to have pizza day with my grandmother. Forget it. And then we would do all of this, whoa, and we would get this into a thing, and then we would put it in a soup bowl with a little bit of olive oil. Let me wipe my hands, excuse me, Judith. Okay, a little bit of olive oil. And then it would rise and come out like this, see? And then we have our dough.
Oh, and it would be all greasy.
Right,
olive
right.
Oil. That's
and
great.
Then, I need
mean?
Some flour, let go of me. I need a little flour, okay? Okay, and then we're gonna make this into our pizza, right? You know, I know there's guys in
Brooklyn. How long does it take to rise?
I know there's guys in Brooklyn. A couple of hours, that's all. You know, you put it a little bit in
look
the sun.
Look at you. You're like, you
can oh, yeah, here. With a cutting.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
All right.
Che la luna.
Mezzumare, mamma mia, me mare da day. All right. All right, so here. Come on, do a little work there. Yeah, there you go. And then we're going to make that edge. You know how we make the edge, remember?
No.
You go around like this, like you're in a pizza parlor.
When
look.
We were doing the shows, when we did a Thanksgiving show, Tony did all the cooking.
Yeah,
so backstage, he did everything.
Cooked for the show.
Clams, oregano, everything.
Yeah, but stay away from that. I killed my sister-in-law. Anyway, here we go. Okay, no, here
like
we go.
Like, for real?
No, I'm kidding, Now, we would have made our fast Pomodoro sauce. And on this one, we would put some sauce in here, right? We'd spread that out.
Oh, my God, I'm so
we'd put
hungry.
Some Parmesan cheese, right? We would do that. And we would put some mozzarella around, okay? All right.
Right.
All right. Then what we would do is, we'd put a little bit of cornmeal on our thing here. Whatever they call this thing.
A bread
and
board.
We put this
a
on.
A pizza board.
We put this on, and then you see this thing will slide. And you can slide that off over here. And Ju, come here, Ju. You gotta be on the cam. There it is, we're on the cam.
Oh my God.
All right. And we have as you can see, we have a pizza stone.
Yes, we do.
Okay? And that's at $5.50. And it comes out like this. This is how it comes out. It's a beautiful pizza. We also, now let me put this down. We also, sometimes what we do too is, my kids really like this one, we make a margarita pizza. Well, we'll take the pizza and we'll just brush on some olive oil,
right.
Salt and pepper,
right.
Then slice a fresh tomato.
Oh.
Cover it with fresh tomato, red onion.
Oh, like this?
Yes, that's the one right there. But a little bit more red onion, some basil, some Parmesan, and some mozzarella. And it's the same thing. And it's there's no sauce on this one, but it's sort of a fresh,
smash.
Natural, yeah.
Right.
And ready audience.
Oh!
All right, now let's have a little booze. Judith?
It's 8 o'clock in the morning.
Let me just say something, Ju. I can't tell you how great it is that you don't have your heels on and I'm as tall as you. But the other thing is, I love you so much. Thank you so much for being here. Okay. Judith Light. We'll be right back.